I am totally geeked about today's video tutorial because I get to have a little fun on Illustrator. I usually do this exercise in my FIT class in the fall, but I didn't get to teach that class this fall, so we didn't get to do our holiday sweater exercise. So I'm doing it here, and I hope you guys have as much fun as I do. So who doesn't like an ugly Christmas sweater for the holidays? Except every time I do this exercise with my students, all the designs I get are anything but ugly. They're actually rather chic. Anywho, what I'm going to show you today is how to create a believable all-over sweater texture with a fun holiday graphic in Illustrator.
Before you get started, check the guides and grid section of your preferences and make sure the grid lines are set to show every 1 inch with subdivisions of 8. Go to the View menu and choose Show Grid. Then zoom in so you can easily see one square of the grid. Set the fill and stroke to no fill and a black stroke. Choose the pen tool and make a V shape in one square to create the knit stitch shape. Try to make it as centered as possible. Use the direct selection tool if necessary to edit and reposition the shape. In the stroke panel, change the cap and corner to a round cap and a round join. Then select width profile number 1. Increase the thickness of the line to 3 point and change the line to a filled object by going to Object, Path, Outline Stroke. Use the bounding box to reshape the size of the knit stitch so that it's contained within one square. Next, open your swatches panel. Choose or create a color and save it as a global process color. You can save any other colors you plan to use as well, but keep in mind that you have a maximum of 5 colors you can use with a Ferrule. Fill the knit stitch with your color and use the tint slider to make it a lighter shade of the color. Then draw a box with the rectangle tool matching the size of one square of the grid. Make it 100% of the color you use for the knit stitch and send it to the back. This is now your repeat and will create the basic knit pattern for your design. Select and drag the box and the stitch into the swatches panel. Zoom out and make a big box on the page filled with a knit pattern. Then expand the pattern, ungroup it, release the clipping mask, and ungroup it again. Using the magic wand, click one red box. This should select all of the red boxes on the page. Lock them by going to Object, Lock Selection. Locking the background boxes will make it much easier for you to select and recolor the knit stitches. One last thing before you begin to color, remove the fill and the stroke color, then go to Select, Same, Fill and Stroke. This will remove additional unpainted objects on the page so that, again, it will be easier for you to recolor your knit stitches. Now you can begin creating your designs by clicking on the knit stitches and recoloring them to create a pattern. If you're repeating a motif like the snowflake, drag a copy and perfectly align the stitches. Then lock the snowflake and select and delete the stitches underneath so you don't have two sets of objects in your pattern. mark your repeat with a guide, and do any additional tweaking to your design. Once you finish the pattern, go to Object, Unlock All to make the background objects active again. Delete any extra stitches you no longer need, and then using the rectangle tool, create a definition box around the repeat of the pattern. Be sure it has no fill or stroke color, and then send it to the back. Lastly, select all of the objects and drag them into the swatches panel.
And once you save your knit swatch, you can fill your sweater with it, scale it down, and rotate and move it as needed. Now this is an all over sweater graphic, but if you wanted something more center front and placed, you can use the same technique. You just wouldn't be creating a repeat. Either way, it's a little time consuming, but a lot of fun. And I love seeing what my students come up with. So if you create a holiday sweater and you use the same technique, post it on Instagram and tag me at 383design. I would love to see it. Thanks for watching this week's video. If you're new to Illustrator for Fashion, make sure you check out the links in the description for more information about my classes. They make great holiday gifts. Also, if you are interested in our fashion business competition, make sure that you enter by this Friday's deadline, December 18th, 2020. And there's a link in the description for more information about that. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share this if you found it helpful. Have a great week, and I'll see you next time.